Hi, this is Kanna Babu. In the last class, we discussed about how to perform, how to display the data in the grid view, how to perform deleting, editing operations, as well as in the last session, insertion operation also. In this video, we'll discuss about selection, paging operation within the grid. Okay. So for more videos, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel. And this is the output of the last session. Is it clear? So we perform the insertion operation, editing, deleting. Now today we'll see selection operation as well as paging operation. Paging means generally if you consider a database, in database some millions of records are existing in the database and you can't display all that records in a single page in the browser. So mostly if you want to display in that case the button on the browser also will increase. The page loading time will take more time. So the beautiful concept is paging. If you open Google also, you can see hardly 10 pages only, 10 links only you can, it will display within the browser. So if you want to perform paging operation within the grid view control, you have one property called allow paging. So here you can go to your design, select right click on grid, go to properties. There you can set the property, allow paging. Allow paging, by default it is false, so I set that property as true. Then automatically page numbers are visible within the grid view control. And here you can see some properties are there, like page size is there. Maximum you can set your page size here. I'll give the page size 2 or 3 you can give, because there are no more records in my table, database table. So I given the page size is 3. So hardly 3 records only will display within the grid view control. Okay. Now, so here whenever, if you want, you can see, press F5, check the output. So whenever user clicks on page number, then one event will fail. That is page index changing event will fail when user clicks on page number. So here you see. So when user, hardly two, 3 records are displayed. Next 3 will display in the next page. For that, you have to write the code in this event. Page index changing event. So stop debugging. And here you can select the grid view, right click, go to properties. There you can find events. There you can find page index changing event. Which event? Page index changing event. Double click on that event and write the code. Any example in grid view, the main portion is how to cache the row index. Now also I want to cache the row index. How to cache the row index? I'll write the code. Grid view 1 dot page index here. Grid view 1 dot page index is equal to e dot new page index. Grid view 1 dot page index is equal to e dot new page index, and here I'll try to give fill data method. Okay, so now here if you observe, if I try to press F5, check the output, then the records will be displayed within the grid view. So here I displayed 3 records for a single page. Okay. Let us see here. Now when user clicks on page number 2, then again the next records will be displayed here. So now let us perform select operation within the grid view. So I have one requirement. So here I will try to I have some select button. Now here I will design some page. So here I will go to table, insert table, number of rows 2, columns 2. And here you can press the tab button, and here I have some other special requirement is there, something like this. So here I will try to go to my toolbox, drag and drop text box control. Here you can drag and drop on text box control from toolbox. Where is text box? Where it is? Yes, here it is. And here drag and drop one more text box, and here one more text box. And here you can take one button control. And here I will write some text, something like enter employee number, and here I will give employee name, and here I will give salary. And here I have one button, some text, just I will give the text as update. Text for the button I will try to give as update. So I will explain my requirement here. There are different requirements are there, depending on the design, the coding also will what change. So you can ask, already here we perform updating operation, but still this is another model. So now my requirement, whenever user select, click on select button, I want to catch that values that are available within the grid view, and I want to display that values within the text boxes. And when I edit the values in the text box and click on update button, I want to update that values to the database table. That is my requirement. Okay. See here, when I click on select button, I want to catch the values 104, Jaydeep, and the salary, and I want to display that values in the text boxes. And when I modify the value in the text box and click on update button, it has to update the record. That is what we are doing some example now. So double click on grid view and write the code. The default event for grid view is selected index changed. See, if you want to catch the row index in footer template, you have to use footer row property. If you want to catch the row index in selected index changed, you have to use selected row property. And if you want to catch the row index in row deleting or row updating, then you have to use e.rowIndex. So here I will try to catch the row index. Here I will try to write some code. Grid view row is equal to, here I will write something like grid view 1 dot selected row. That's it. Selected row. So it will automatically catch the selected row. Which row select button you click, that row values will come. So in that row, I want to catch the text boxes. Is it clear? In that row, I want to catch the labels. These labels are available inside the item template. I'll catch the labels. So I'll try to write label L1 is equal to typecast label of row dot find control of. Here I'll try to give label 1. Is it clear? And here, similarly, label 2 and label 3. Catch the values. Which row select button was clicked, that row values you have to catch. Label 1, label 2, and label 3. Here you have L2. Here you have L3. Is it clear, everyone? So now I want to, catch the values. And here you can go to your design. There you can see the text boxes, see the IDs. Text box 4, text box 5, text box 6. I want to display that values in these text boxes 4, 5, 6. So I'll try to write something like text box 4 dot text is equal to L1 dot what? Text. Text box 5 dot text is equal to L2 dot what? Text. Text box 6 dot text is equal to L3 dot text. So automatically the values are displayed within the grid view. Let us see. Text boxes. So when user clicks on select button, I want to catch that values. Then I want to display the values in the text boxes, outside the grid. See here, when a user clicks on select button. And here when user clicks on select button. Right now, if you want, you can modify the values here. Is it clear? You can modify the values also. Is it clear? Some RAM. I want to select this one. So here I want to update RAM, employee name as well as salary. And click on update. I want to update that record. So what to do that? In that case, double click on this button control and write the code. Okay, what type of code we have to write here? Your connection oriented architecture. Create the connection. Open the connection, pass the query, execute the query, close the connection. Just the query will what change. Is it clear? Create the connection, open the connection, pass the query. So I'll just change the query. And my values are available inside the text boxes, these text boxes 4, 5, 6. So I'll try to write update query. Update EMP set. Ename is equal to single quote. Double quotes plus, here I'll give something like text box 4 dot text. Text box 4 dot text. And here I'll try to give comma salary. Salary is equal to single quote double quote plus. Let us check your salary column. Is it salary? Salary, not sal. So here you can give SALARY is equal to plus. text box 5 dot text, 4 dot text, 5 dot text, update, no, sorry, so don't update employee number. So this is 5, employee name, salary is what, 6. Here I'll try to write where condition, where, here I'll try to give e number, where e number is equal to single quote, double quote, plus. Here I'll try to give text box 4 dot text. Update table name, set e name is equal to text box 5 dot text, salary is equal to text box 6 dot text. Based on employee number, I'm updating actually. So execute the query, press F5. Check the output. And after updating, I want to fill the data. So that I wanted to view the updated record within my grid view. Okay, so here I'll try to call fill data. Here I will call fill data method. Fill data. And again, I want to clear the text boxes. Text box 4 dot text is equal to empty. Is it clear? And similarly, text box 5 dot text, text box 6 dot text. I want to clear the text boxes 5 as well as 6. Now press F5, check the output. Is it clear? So whenever user clicks on select button, catch the row index. In order to catch the row index, you have one property called selected row. And in that row index, in that row, you catch that controls, text boxes, sorry, labels. Is it clear? Here I want to update Jaydeep. I'll update his name Jaydeep to Jaydeep Krishna, or I'll give something like Jaydeep Bana, I will give. And here I'll give some salary I'll try to give, click on update. Now you see, whenever you do any modification, it will automatically update in your table. I hope you understood. Okay, for more videos, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel and Facebook group. As well as for more updates, you just share and like and press the notification also. And we are discussing about the, I'm planning to develop some series of videos on GitView. In the next video, I'll discuss some more examples also. Thank you. Have a nice day.